don't want to crawl. I want to go here out here.
I know you do. Do you have a fucking yard?
Well, I can get all the cows. I can go do it out there. There's too many holes. I'm going to break some shit. Oh, yeah. Look at my fucking... We got... Look.
Oh, your roof thing got
blown
off.
Yeah, I lost it all.
That shit must got rough here then.
No, it got totally rough. Well, there was a hell of a storm. Let me get my other phone. So we had a super strong storm come through. We actually specifically went to Walmart because we saw the warnings around us where it was coming, and we thought, well, let's not be here in case it gets bad. Let's go be in a real structure. And I lost two pieces of, I thought it was both ends. I guess it's side by side. Yeah, I lost two pieces of my sheet metal. Oh, it is a side by side. Okay, yeah. So I lost those two right there. 14 screws. Oh, apologize, wrong side. 14 screws in each one of those bad boys. And it ripped it right off there. But they're not the longest screws. So. It's the only one I found. There's like one and one more in there. Did bend this one end right there. But not too terribly bad. They could have been a lot worse. And that is some super heavy gauge. Well, I guess it bent a little bit down there on the side, I see, but not too bad considering they went flying across it because they were way back here on the ground. They were in the backyard here. And so our trash can lid was blown off down there, you know, by the road. Our trash can faces that way, so the lid came off, you know, towards us, which is the same way. That got blown off, so the wind must have just been coming straight up the hill. And, it always is extra bad when the wind, when the storms come in that way, because they never come from that way. So, okay. Update done. Well, I just watched a video on how to secure your roof, if you got a hole in it. And I really can't believe I didn't do this. Fucking when my son moved out years ago and I knew there was a hole. I've just been in such denial that I'm ever gonna fucking actually live in this trailer even though I've been living here for 7 years. What? Like, I don't... Or, yes, I don't know what the fuck is wrong with me. But, let's charge these batteries up, maybe. I was just talking to the old lady about being able to... That's this green one. Being able to, shut the fuck up! Don't be coming here and have babies. Psst! Psst! Get out! Psst! No! Psst! Get out of here! They have babies in here. Get out! Psst! Motherfucker. Well, that ain't it. Maybe it's unplugged out there. Just talking to the old lady about actually getting electricity run out here sometime this year, too. I mean, this year we'll be able to get so much done. This year we'll be able to get the vast majority of everything house needed done. Oh yeah, it's not plugged in. Including eliminating this bullshit. Get actual electric conduit. Run out here to the shed and out here to my little thingy here. Got some badass light bulbs to hang there. So I looked at tarp, how to secure a tarp to the roof, and you're supposed to, like, screw the tarp into some 2x4s or into a 2x4 and then roll the tarp up a few times, and then you go ahead and screw that to the roof. So while that seems like a good idea, I mean, I know it's a good idea, I saw it from a hurricane company, I don't think that's the way I'm gonna do it. I may come back and do it later. I think I'm just literally gonna staple that bitch down to the fucking roof. I think is the way I'm gonna do it. I got my staple gun here, and I got my staples, and I think I'm just gonna go to town and staple the fuck out of it, because I don't. And then I may come back and screw some random 2x4s down over that, just to kind of lock it down. Oh look, I'm just finishing editing a video for y'all. Just finished editing a video. I don't know if y'all have actually seen the Dex Pad in operation, because you know, it's so weird. I guess they think it's food time, but it's not. That don't happen for like several more hours. See, how stupid is it they did this to the gate? Some shit got stolen from my sister-in-law's house shortly before Big died, and they mocked me for having a gate all these years, and then all of a sudden they put a gate up. But the dumbasses got it swinging outward, so then you can't pull in the fucking driveway and open the gate. Like, you morons. Like, what are you even doing? They should have had the gate swing in, or both ways. Yeah, pole should have been back fucking 8 inches, and then the gate could swing either way. But no, don't fucking do shit smart. Be a dumbass. I don't know how that didn't fucking occur to them. And Bobo's stupid ass is talking about moving fucking these giant light poles because he doesn't like where they're at. And they would just like them better. And I'm like, you're a fucking idiot, dude. You're a fucking idiot. Why don't you put fucking posts that you're actually putting in the ground in the correct place first and not worry about goddamn light poles that have been there for 25 fucking years or are fucking fine and that you don't even have fucking, that you don't even utilize. You don't even turn them on. See? Did you see him chasing the fucking cat? Look what I can do. Stuart like a motherfucker. Stop it out! Stop it out? Yeah, stop it out. Or cut it out even. Stop it out. Stop it out, guys. Okay? Stop it out. Stop chasing the goddamn cats, you son of a bitch! Since y'all all seem to think you're so freaking hungry, see Orange Boy's staying close, letting all the holes in his legs fill up. He's finally putting some weight back on too. Aren't you, buddy? You were skinny fucking mini for a minute. You were skinny mini for a minute. Yeah, you were. Look at that fucking leg. Oh my goodness. That fucking leg. Look at that fucking leg. Not even to mention the wounds on his head he had. That are mostly healed up now. Oh, poor little battle cat. And these two little bastards that don't like me at all. Why are you on top of her? Got some stain. I probably ought to have my work belt on, but I don't think the stapler's gonna fall out of the back of my pants. I got my staples, and I got my camera, and I got my tarp, I got my pocket knife, I got my gloves. Okay, and I don't really need my gloves. My hands might get cold if I fall through the roof and I'm stuck up here for a few hours. Yay, it landed. Okay. Here and paint these eaves. They're actually surprisingly not as dry rotted as I thought, but look at that fucking hole. Oh god, I don't like heights. I forgot about this. I forgot how much I don't like this part. Yeah, look at that shit. Like, that's not good, right? Oh my goodness. Like, how do we not have a fucking leak in the kitchen yet? Yeah, I don't like this at all. Oh yeah, that corner too, completely gone. Not fucking good. This shit at all. Me not okay. Yeah, this is so close to the edge. This sucks, man. But I'm glad to see that all those shingles I've seen fly off the roof are actually not exposing. You know, like here, we got shingles missing, but there's still shingles underneath because of the overlap. So, it's not as bad as I thought. But yeah, when they pull all this shit off, I'm assuming they'll have to pull the shingles off. But maybe not. Maybe they just go right over it with sheet metal. But they definitely have to cut around the bad areas and fix that first. So that's the edge that really bothers me. Oh my goodness, I might need to get the tractor for some of this stuff. You know, I had a landlord in California. And that dude was re-roofing my house. I mean, he had all these Mexican workers, right? And they were actually re-roofing my house. But for some reason, he thought it'd be a grand idea to help him. And he proceeded to step right off the roof backwards. Well, that's not gonna work at all, is it? Well, it might. It might work if I actually had staples. That'd probably help the situation a little bit. Yeah, I would not really. What the fuck? I would not be productive. How'd it go like that? I'm not sure how productive I'd be on a rooftop work crew. I had a buddy in San Diego, Crazy K from South Bay. He took a fucking job. Oh, yep, too many staples, son of a bitch. He took a job washing windows on high rises. I may have told y'all that before. Come on. But I couldn't believe that shit. He freaked out at first. But I guess after a few weeks and shit, he got used to it. I'm like, I don't think I'd get used to that. I mean, I know I wouldn't get used to it because you wouldn't catch me up there in order to get used to it. So how about that? How about that? Oh yeah, I don't know if this is gonna... I mean, I guess it'll be all right for temporarities until I can go buy a couple of 2x4s down the road. Yeah, I probably shouldn't go too crazy because these are not going to hold it in that well. And I'm definitely going to have to come back for screws and 2x4s in a minute. So let's just throw enough to hold it down tight. It's supposed to rain for like the next week straight. And I'd already been planning on doing this. But I wasn't necessarily gonna do it today. I bought everything yesterday and I was gonna do it sometime over the next few days. But, oh yeah, I already feel drops. Best not to put off till tomorrow what can be done today. What's that? What's right there? That looks like a tarp, like the one I just put on the roof. But that's actually got some holes in it, so I couldn't use that one anyway. If I didn't know any better walking through this yard, I'd say we got a sinkhole forming. And rained in days. I mean, it drizzled the other morning, but not like rain. Oh, actually, it did pour ass. Never mind. I apologize. I got a bad memory. You know, so the reason I used the tractor last time is I got so much overhang. I don't want to bend the fuck out of my tin, right? I don't want to bend the fuck out of my tin. But I don't think I have to worry about it, really. It's probably strong enough. Yeah, I got the thick gauge, so I think I'll be okay. Okay, Katayams Katats, I must disturb your beauty sleeps, the one-eyed fucking monster over here. Hi, little fucking weird male with the weird eyes. How you doing? How you doing? How you doing? Oh yeah, that appears to be shit, which is awesome. It blew off the fucking roof. directly into a pile of shit. Something to be remarked upon. Alright. That's the one. Oh, I think I hear some thunder. Some thunder dunder. Oh, my poor little bent up sheet metal. It actually bent back, I think. Which is awesome. Pretty sure I'll be using the screws. Since they're longer, it shouldn't be a problem going through the same holes. Hopefully. Worst case, maybe I can just spin the sheet metal around so I'm going through the same sheet metal holes, but different wood holes. What is this? Okay, let's see how strong I built this thing, right? Looks like the holes would line up either way. So yeah, I guess we'll just try to drive down longer. I mean, they're a full half inch longer, so I think they'll be fine. I definitely feel the whole thing rocking just now. When I shifted away, and I could feel the whole thing going like this. That's not good. That's a little bit sketch. Seems like I need some fucking shear force bracing. Keep in mind, I have no idea what I'm doing.
No, I have no idea what I'm doing when I built this.
Why would I have like little rust spots forming in some places? What's that about, I wonder? I got so many screws coming up. I totally need to come through here and like redo most of these with longer screws. My son put a lot of these in and I'm not impressed with his, he got a lot of them cattywampus. Not a lot of them, but enough of them. Okay, that'll probably be good for now.